my ghost on this episode. We talk support clubs, support gear. Is it okay for you to wear support gear without getting into situations out there in the street? We get into it on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Chopper Sosa, I'm your host for the evening, and today we're going to talk about support clubs, support patches. I've gotten so many emails, inboxes about it, and the first thing I want you to do, like we do every time on this channel, is to hit me with that pal ghosting. And that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on tools, doing what you do. And just basically, if you don't ride, that you're down with the road. That's how you let me know. Okay, so let's get into it. First things first, what is a support club? A support club is any club, male or female. There are male and female MCs. There's also ACs. Shout to my ACs. They're a big part of the community that we hardly talk about. But you could be an AC, an SC, MC. It doesn't matter what type of club it is, you can be a supporter. And what a supporter is a club that wears the insignia on their cut, showing that they represent for a larger 1% club. And basically, the way you become a support is either that 1% club is the one who gave you your blessing, which is giving you the okay to wear your cut and to rep your club and to come out with your club, or you did a patch over where for whatever reason that club assumed a position over you and you now are part of their coalition, or you're underneath their, you're part of their support and you wear the patch that represents them. Now a support is like a minor league system for a 1% club. So you will have people in the support that eventually graduate to that 1% club. It's just part of the way this works. They'll take the cream of the crop a lot of times. And it's not a bad thing. It's just the way things are. Like certain clubs are just in a hierarchy. So there's misconceptions about support clubs. Like people think that they're just straight up lackeys. And I'm here to tell you, like, don't get caught slipping. There's some support clubs here that are official. Like just because they're underneath a 1% club doesn't mean that they're not about that life, and it doesn't mean that they don't control certain areas. There's even supports that wear diamonds. Like there's a lot of things to this that you need to know before you get into it. Now if you're trying to create your club and you go about things the right way and you go to the dominant, there is a possibility that they tell you that if you open up, they'll give you the blessing, but you have to become a support. Now, if you're gonna be a support, you have to understand the pros and cons of being a support. There's negatives and there's positives. You will be underneath them, so you're affiliated with them. You'll wear a patch that represents them. So if you're in a rival territory, you now assume those problems because you're representing a patch of that club. Any heat from police, you now assume that. You are now affiliated with that club. Any mistakes you make out on the set, if you have a member that goes and disrespects somebody or does some dumb shit or gets in the heat with police, you're now putting that heat on the Big Brother club. So you gotta be very careful and know that if you're gonna go in and be a support club, you have to be prepared for what comes. And you just, there's nothing wrong with it, and there's a lot of pros to it too. Because now, when you go party, you might have all the other support clubs. Those are now your allies. So you have a lot of people to party with. You have a lot of people that come support your functions when you do stuff. So there's a lot of positives too. And people in the comments that are in support clubs, let me know some pros. I want to hear some pros, because I don't want to make this channel all about negativity like some of these other channels where they're only promoting faces and cases. Like, we're not doing that on Demons Row. I want to focus on positivity in the culture. Like, I want to give game, but I also want to focus on positivity, because it's not all negativity and it's not all shootouts and it's not all fights and it's not all people getting their cuts taken by one percenters. That is not what the game is about. The game is all about respect. People have asked me if they're in a support club and they know that they're going in the territory of a rival, can they take it off their cut, or could they have two cuts, one with it, one without it? No. Once you're in bed with that club, you made a dedication to them. You can lose your blessing, they can take your cuts. Like, if you were to not have that patch on there, it could be a major problem. Like, your whole club could get shut down. So also, when there's, you're gonna have mandatory events, mandatory bike runs, just things that you'll have like a calendar and it'll have a whole bunch of events, and you'll have to go to those and support that 1% club. And when they go out and do certain things, you're expected to support, because that's what you are, your support club. There's misconceptions that they get involved in your club business. The only way that they would get involved is if it's them trying to protect you from something, or if they have to intervene because something happened. But as far as like day-to-day club business, they're not going to be at your meetings getting involved with what you're doing with your club, telling you what to do with your club, how to run your club. That's just not the way it works. You're two separate entities. You just support the club. You wear the patch to signify that you represent, and this is who you're running with. So you've picked a side when you do that. So you have to understand that when you're involved with a support club, you've already picked a side. There's no in-betweens or I'm cool with them and I'm cool with you. There's none of that. You can't associate with rivals. You know, it's just you have to know what you're getting into when you get into these things. Now, if you have any questions on support clubs, hit me in the comments with that. Let's get into the support gear. Now, you'll have support gear that's made for members of the club, where it would have diamonds, it would have the club's insignia on it, that type of deal. You're not allowed to wear that as a supporter. As a supporter, you wear things that say support your local. It'll have the same font, the club font, but it won't have the actual insignia or the actual diamond on it. You can't wear that type of stuff. Now, if you're a family member of a club member, that's a different type of support gear. That's the type of gear that we're talking about here. If you're a person that's not affiliated with the club, they do, some clubs do sell their merch. There's nothing wrong with that. But understand, whether you ride or not, if you're wearing support gear, it's picking a side. So if you're in some town where their rival is at, do not wear that shirt. You're not held to the same standard as a support club. You're just wearing support merch. In my opinion, support merch is like keep it in the hood type thing. Like, you could rep the clothes when you're going to their parties, when you're going to their events, if you're cool with them, if you're friends of them. It's cool, the merch is fine to wear. Never buy the stuff online. Like, I'ma stress this a million times over. Like, anything online can get you caught up. You don't know, and also you're robbing from the club, because this is a way that they fund things. So if you buying it offline, you're not getting it from the source. Now you're stealing and you're infringing. You don't ever wanna do that. You wanna have the official merch from them anyway. It's gonna look better and feel better. And when you do it, like I said, don't just be in random places and not knowing what you're wearing and then get caught up by a rival, because they're gonna think that you're actually a member, maybe in soft colors. They're gonna look at you like a member that's just hanging out but not riding or wearing this cut. So you gotta be careful with that. So where do you get the support gear from? Only from that club, from their clubhouse, from one of the members. if they have an online shop, but it has to be their club's official online shop. Like, and you have to make sure from a member that this is official, because if not, you're getting some shit that somebody from Japan or China or whatever is trying to take advantage and infringe on the logo of that club. Understand, even if you're not wearing a cut and you're wearing support gear, you can be profiled by the police. You cannot wear one club support gear one day and then another club support gear another day. That is a violation, and that can get you in some shit. So I would definitely advise, when you do support gear, that means you're picking a side. So I advise, if you're picking a side, pick that side. Don't play the middle. In my opinion, if you're not in a club, you shouldn't wear the gear. But if you're very close with members, a good friend, but you just are not ready to dedicate to being a club member, but you go hang out and your friends are in the club and you're supporting them, that's cool. But don't go too far with it. If you're gonna be riding and stuff like that, understand, when you ride, you're getting into whatever situations they're gonna get into, because people are gonna see it and they're gonna assume that you're with them. So there's nothing wrong with support gear, just know how to maneuver with it. I want you to take this and share it on your timeline, because we need to raise more awareness of how these things go, so we don't have Chris Brown, Young Jeezy situations where people are wearing fake patches or fake support gear, or just ordering things online because they're fascinated with a certain club that they've seen in the news or whatever it may be. And I just want to stress to everybody in this community, stop supporting any channel, any source that is just exploiting the culture. Any channels that are promoting people's cases and faces, stop supporting that bullshit. There's a lot of people smiling in your face, acting like they're pro MC, but they just want to get clicks, so they'll throw anybody under the bus to get those clicks. Stay away from these cops online. I've been learning. I've been seeing people that troll my channel, and then I look on some of the cop channels, because I've been doing my research on some of these cop motorcycle club channels, and I've noticed the people that have been spamming on the cop channels, they're cops. So just be careful on who you interact with, who you tell stuff on here. Like, everything we talk about is surface shit. We wanna bring the culture up. Everybody in this Demons Roll community, I want you to work with me so we could unite this shit and roll as one, and dead a lot of the bullshit that goes on. Listen, get these ghosting hoodies to let me know you ghosting with me, you wanna support the show. The links are always underneath. I got the merch shelf right under every video. Go down right now, take a second out, just look, swipe, see what you like. I got every color of everything. Even if it's a black display, I still have every color. So I wear a lot of black, so it's just, it's hard for, you know, people to understand that there's a lot of colors, so I try to put it out there more. But if we have every color, whatever your club is, if it's your color, it's not affiliated with any club, it's Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.